ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நம ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி சம் நம்பர் 10 ஃப்ரம் எக்ஸசைஸ். ஃபைண்ட் நியூ ப்ராஃபிட் ஷேரிங் ரேஷியோ. வி ஹாவ் 6 க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் கிவன் அண்டர் திஸ் டாபிக் அண்ட் வி வில் சால்வ் ஒன் பை ஒன். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன், ஆர் அண்ட் டி ஆர் பார்ட்னர்ஸ் இன் அ ஃபர்ம் ஷேரிங் ப்ராஃபிட்ஸ் இன் த ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் 3:2. எஸ் ஜாயின்ஸ் த ஃபர்ம் அண்ட் R surrenders 1/4 of his share and T surrenders 1/5 of his share in favor of S. So we have to find out the new profit sharing ratio. Sum number 10. So now the existing partners of profit sharing ratio is 3:2. That is the old profit sharing ratio. So old PSR of R and T is 3:2. And the new partner who is getting admitted is S. And this partner is getting 1/4 from R and 1/5 from T. Okay, so now we'll see how much R and T surrender. Okay, how much is surrendered? So surrender by R is, out of his share of 3/5, he is surrendering 1/4. Okay, so he surrenders 3/20 of his share, and T, out of his 2/5 share, he surrenders 1/5. Okay, so 2/25 is the share surrendered by T in favor of S. Okay, so now we'll find what is the new profit sharing ratio. To calculate the new profit sharing ratio, first we have to subtract the surrendered ratio of R from his old ratio. Okay, so his old ratio is 3/5 and he surrenders 3/20 for S, isn't it? So now subtract that. Twenty is the LCM, and 12 - 3, so you will get 9/20. So this is the new ratio of R. And for T, out of 2/5 from his old ratio, he surrenders 2/25. Okay, so 2/25. 10 - 2, so 8/25 is his new ratio. Now S is getting 3/20 from R and 2/25 from T, isn't it? So this much when they surrender, it is going to be the profit share of, total profit share of S, isn't it? So 3/20 + 2/25, 100 is the LCM here, so 15 + 8, so his new share is 23/100. So just make the denominators equal. So here into 5, so this becomes 145. So here multiply with 4, so the denominator becomes 100. Was a 32. Okay, so the new profit sharing ratio of R, T and S is 45:32:23. Okay, now coming to the second sum, A and B are partners. They admit C for 1/4 share. In future, the ratio between A and B would be 2:1. Okay, So we'll see the solution. Yes. Now, the mutual ratio, that is the new mutual ratio between A and B is 2:1. Okay. So now, how much share he is getting? C is getting admitted for 1/4 share of profit. So assume the total share is 1 and subtract C's share, that is C's 1/4 share should be subtracted from the total share. So this becomes 3/4, which is left over for the other partners to share. Okay. So now, out of this 3/4 share, A and B have a mutual understanding of sharing it as 2:1. Okay. So now, what is the share of A? So out of this 3/4 share left over, they are deciding to have 2/3. Okay. 2/3 is the decided share for A. So 3 cancels. So you will have 2/4. Next, for B, out of this 3/4 leftover share, he is deciding to take 1/3. Okay. So he will get 1/4 of the share. Now, what is the share of C? C is getting admitted for 1/4 as given in the question. So the new profit sharing ratio is A, B and C is 2:1:1. Okay. Next we'll see the third sum. Sum 3 under 10. So first we will have to write the old PSR of A and B. So the old PSR of A and B is 3:2. Okay. And C is admitted for 1/5 share. Okay. C's share is 1/5 and he is getting that share 1/5 from A and 4/5 from B. So C's share is actually 1/5 and out of this 1/5, he is getting 1/5 from A and 4/5 from B. So we have to find how much C is going to acquire from A and B. So C acquires from A, out of this 1/5, he is going to get 1/5 from A. So he is actually going to get 1/25 of A's share. And he is going to acquire, how much he is going to acquire from B is, out of this 1/5, he is going to get 4/5 from B. Okay. So 4/25 he is going to get, or 4/25 he is going to get from B. Okay. Now we have to find out what is the new profit sharing ratio. So here we can understand that when C is going to acquire 1/25 from A, it means that A has sacrificed 1/25 and C is acquiring from B 4/25. It means that B is sacrificing 4/25 for the sake of C. Okay. So now we'll find out what is the new profit sharing ratio. So the new profit sharing ratio is, for A, his old share is 3/5 and he sacrifices 1/25 in favor of C. So LCM for this is 25. So 14/25 is his new ratio. And for B, his old ratio is 2 by 5 and he is sacrificing 4 by 25. Okay. 25. 6 by 25. Okay. And C is getting 1 by 25 from A and 4 by 25 from B, which is 5 by 25. Ultimately, it is going to be 1 by 5. It is the same. Okay. So now the new ratio of these three partners are 14 is to 6 is to 5. Now we'll see sum number 4. Sum number 4, XYZ are partners in the ratio of 3 is to 2 is to 1. W joins the firm as a new partner for 1/6 share in profits. Z would retain his old share or original share. Okay, so here in this question, already there are three partners and now fourth partner is getting admitted, but one among the existing partner is going to retain his share as it is. So it means he is not going to sacrifice. He is not going to sacrifice for the sake of the new partner. Okay. Sum number 4, the old PSR of X, Y and Z is 3 is to 2 is to 1. Okay. And W is getting admitted for 1/6 share of profit. Right. So now the same method once again, let profit be assumed as 1 or the total share be assumed as 1. And here what we are going to do is W is going to have 1/6 share and Z is going to retain his 1/6 share. Okay. So shares retained. Otherwise, shares of Z and W. So they are both are going to have their 1/6 ratio as it is. Okay. So 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. It's going to be 2 by 6, 1/3. Okay. So now we have to subtract this 1/3 from the total share so that leftover will be shared among X and Y. So 1 minus 1 by 3. This is actually the remaining share. So 2 by 3. Okay. So 2 by 3 is the leftover share which has to be shared among X and Y. Now to find out the new profit sharing ratio. First for X, out of this 2/3 of profit, he is going to take in the old ratio itself, isn't it? That is, old ratio should be multiplied with the remaining share so that we will get the new ratio of X. Okay. So this is 3 by 5. Okay. So 2 by 5 is the new ratio of X. Next for Y, out of this 2/3, he is going to get 2 by 5. So it is 4 by 15. Right? And now for Z, Z is going to have his share as it is, that is 1 by 6. And W is going to have it as 1 by 6. Now we just have to have a common denominator for everything, for all ratios. Okay. So here it becomes, we can just have 30 as the common denominator as it is easy to multiply. Okay. So here we'll have twelve by 30. Here we'll have 8 by 30. And here we'll have 5 by 30. And here also 5 by 30. Okay. So the new profit sharing ratio of X, Y, Z and W is 12:8:5:5. Okay. Now, sum number 5 is going to be the same pattern of sum number 4. So, you take as homework. Now, we'll see sum number 6. A, B are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. C is admitted for 1/4 share and A and B decide to share equally in future. Okay, now we'll solve this. Number 6, A and B are the old partners. So, the old PSR of A and B is 3:2. And C is admitted for 1/4 share. So, you just assume total share as 1 and C's share is 1 by 4. So, remaining share is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4. Okay. So, now to find out the new profit sharing ratio, of A, the old ratio multiplied with the remaining share. So, 9 by 20. And for B, old ratio multiplied with the remaining ratio. Okay. So, this is the normal thing what we will do, isn't it? So, this is the normal method where we will use the remaining share multiplied with their old ratio to find out the new ratio. But in this sum, they have given that A and B are going to share the remaining share equally, isn't it? So, we are not supposed to do the same thing. What we have to do is for A, out of this 3 by 4, he is going to take equally, isn't it? So, 3 by 8. And for B, again, 3 by 4 is going to be shared equally among them. So, 3 by 8. Now, what is the share of C? C is taking 1/4 of share. So, just equalize the denominator. So, we'll be getting 2 by 8. So, the new profit sharing ratio is 3:2. So, just for comparison, I have did this, children. We have been following this method till now. But here in this question, there is a statement given that the remaining share will be shared among A and B in equal ratio. Okay, so this 3 by 4 is shared equally among A and B, and that gives the new profit sharing ratio of 3 partners A, B, and C. Okay, thank you, children.